Now, in both the cases, we've seen that demand curve slopes downward. Now, if this is the axis, we've seen that demand curve slopes downward. Let's understand why does the demand curve slope downward. First, cost utility matching. When a consumer is purchasing a product, he purchases it to satisfy his wants. So higher the satisfaction derived from a product, more is the quantity of that product that he purchases. Let's take an example here. I am purchasing a Cadbury chocolate. Now the Cadbury chocolate costs rupees 10. The cost is rupees 10. And the satisfaction level, the utility level that it gives me is 100, let's say. Now, if I convert these utility or the satisfaction level into rupees and I say I am getting a satisfaction of 100 rupees, will I not want to consume more of that commodity? Because I am getting it only for rupees 10 and I am getting a utility of 100 rupees. So what I do is I tend to buy more of that product. So when I buy a second product and consume, what happens is the law of diminishing marginal utility applies. Earlier I got a satisfaction level of 100, now I get a satisfaction level of 60 only. Price in terms of rupees was 10 and this is utility was 100 for the first unit. When I purchase the second unit, the price remains the same but the utility derives comes down to 60, but still the satisfaction level is higher than the cost. So I again go in the market and purchase one more unit of, that is one more chocolate of Cadbury. But this time the utility that I get comes to 25. Because I am having more and more of it. So satisfaction level derived from it is going on decreasing because law of diminishing marginal utility applies. In this case, again the utility or the satisfaction level derived is more than the cost. So I again go to the market and purchase one more unit of the chocolate. And now I get a satisfaction which is equivalent to 10 rupees. Generally, consumers tend to stop their consumption here because if they go in the market and purchase one more unit, the satisfaction level that they will derive will obviously be less than the cost. And no consumer would like to incur a loss on his consumption in terms of satisfaction. So the consumer tends to stop at the level where his utility and cost are matching. So in this case, we see that the consumer is consuming more and more units of that good. And he tends to stop where the cost and utility is matching. Because of this reason, the demand curve tends to slope downward. Now when the price of this product goes down, he tends to consume more. He was getting the chocolate for rupees 10. Now if he gets the chocolate for rupees 8, he'll again go in the market and consume because now the satisfaction level has again gone up because of price going down. So what happens is demand tends to increase. The demand curve slopes downward with a fall in price. Next point is income effect. Now, income effect says that as the income of the individual rises, the disposable money in his hand increases. And as the money in his hand increases, what happens is he tends to consume more and more of that product. Now, let's assume a case where the income in the hand of the consumer is not rising, but the price is falling. The consumer earned 2 rupees and demand in quantity. Let's assume that the consumer is earning an income of 1,000 rupees per month. Now, if the product that he wants to buy is costing him 100 rupees, he can buy 10 units of that product within his income. Now, if the price of the product falls to 50 rupees, income remaining same, how many units can he purchase? Now, he can purchase 20 units of the same product. Now, what has happened here is, though the absolute income in the hands of the consumer has remained the same, the real income has increased. He was earlier able to buy 10 products with the same amount of income. Now he is able to buy 20 products with that particular level of income. Because the income, disposable money in his hand has increased. The purchasing power of the money in his hand has increased. So what has happened with the fall in price, now he can purchase more of that commodity. And generally, the consumers tend to purchase more of the commodity when they have more of income in their hands. The next point is substitution effect. In substitution effect, what happens is when the price of a product increases, the consumers of that product tend to buy the substitute of that product. In our case, let's say Pepsi and Coke. Pepsi is a substitute of Coke. Coke is a substitute of Pepsi. Now, there are certain consumers who consume Pepsi. Now, when the price of Pepsi rises, these consumers shift to Coke. Now, what happens is, because of this reason, the price goes up, the consumption of Coke falls. When the price furthermore goes up, the consumption of Coke furthermore falls. This leads to a downward falling demand curve. एक एक पॉइंट एक्सप्लेन करके ना वो इंक डिलीट कर देता हूँ वहां से. नहीं नहीं तो वो सब वो मिक्स हो जाएगा. कौन सा किसका क्या है. द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज अराइवल ऑफ न्यू कंज्यूमर्स. व्हाट हैपेंस इज व्हेन द प्राइस ऑफ अ प्रोडक्ट फॉल्स, it opens up the market for some more buyers who earlier could not afford the product. Now, with the fall in the price, those consumers which earlier could not afford now can afford the product and they tend to buy the product. What happens is, because of this thing, the demand curve This was the earlier price and quantity demanded. With the fall in price, now more consumers are consuming this product. So, the consumption has increased because of fall in price. This leads to the demand curve falling downwards. The last point is multiple uses. When a product has multiple uses and when its price falls, people tend to use it for more purposes. For example, electricity. Electricity can be used for various reasons, like for cooking, for heating, for doing all regular things at our houses. But many people do not use electricity for cooling purposes, citing cost reasons. But what happens is, when the electricity costs come down, people tend to use it for cooling and heating purposes as well. So, the consumption of electricity rises with the fall in price. This leads to a downward sloping demand curve.